Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to NaVideo. Today we are going to talk about the radius, the radio, of convergence of the cosine of x Taylor series expansion and the sine of x Taylor series expansion. Two radios in one video. Let's go ahead and get started. Just like with the exponential function, we are, well, just going to make use of the ratio test you find in your anal one notes. So you see, a series is nothing but the infinite summation of sequences. So those are our ans, and the ratio test just tells us that we have the limit as n approaches infinity of the absolute value of a, n plus 1, over a n. And if this thing is strictly less than 1, well, this series converges absolutely for all the given values of x that we plug in here. We will see what those values of x are actually. This time I'm not going to make a mistake. Hopefully last time I said something correctly, but I've written something wrong on the blackboard. This happens from time to time. I'm terribly sorry for this. So let's go ahead and get started with the cosine at first. I'm going to refer to this limit right here as just capital L. It's easier to write. So we are going to take the limit of the absolute value of, this is going to be quite a mess, plug the n plus 1 into here at first. So negative 1 to the n plus 1th power x to the 2n plus 2 times n plus 1 power. So don't make a mistake here. You have to plug n plus 1 into here, so separately, over 2 times n plus 1 factorial. Okay, you see, this is how it works. Over this term basically itself. So negative 1 to the nth power x to the 2nth power over 2n factorial. Okay, taking the absolute value on everything. This is looking so good, it's just a huge fraction right here. Okay, so you see this negative 1 to the nth power and this negative 1 to the nth power would cancel out to a negative 1. But since we're taking the absolute values, it's multiplicative, we can take the absolute value of this negative 1, meaning we are going to get rid of this negative 1 overall, because absolute value of negative 1 is just positive 1. Okay, with that out of the way, we got rid of this right here. Why not distribute the 2 into everything on here? And let's take the reciprocal here. So we are ending up with the limit of absolute value of x to the 2 times n plus 2. We're going to take the reciprocal, meaning we're going to bring this up to the top, times 2n factorial over, okay, down here we have x to the 2nth power, and then we have, well, times 2n plus 2 factorial. You see, this is what we are going to get right now. If we take a closer look, this x to the 2nth power is going to cancel out. So we have x squared up here. And down here, what is 2n plus 1 factorial? This is nothing but 2n plus 2 factorial. This is nothing but 2n plus 2 times 2n plus 1 times 2n factorial. So if we would write this out to 2n plus 2 times 2n plus 1 times 2n factorial, you are going to see that this and that is going to cancel out in the end to x squared over this chunk right here. So we are going to take the limit of the absolute value of x squared over 2n plus 2 times 2n plus 1. And don't forget, we are going to take the limit as n approaches infinity. You can distribute this absolute value into the numerator and denominator. In the numerator, it's just going to stay as the absolute value of x squared. But down here, those are all natural numbers. That's the property of the factorial. So the absolute value of this chunk is just the chunk itself down here. And if we take the limit as n approaches infinity, this is some finite number over infinity, basically goes to zero. So it doesn't matter which value of x we take, this thing is going to zero for n to infinity, meaning our radius of convergence is infinite in this case. So it doesn't matter what complex or real value you plug in for your x right here, it really doesn't matter, it goes to zero in the limit. And now we can do the same spiel for our sine up here. Let me write everything out. So I've written everything out and you see it's even more of a mess just because of this n plus 1 up here. So once again, we can just factor everything out and take the reciprocal of this fraction down here. So getting rid of the complex fraction. Once again, our limit as n approaches infinity is going to be referred of as capital L. So we have capital L of. Up here we have negative 1 to the n plus 1th power. Then we have x to the 2n plus 1 plus 2 power, I'm going to put it this way, times 2n plus 1 factorial over. What do we have down here now? So we have 2n plus 2 plus 1 factorial times negative 1 to the nth power. And then we have x to the 2n plus 1th power. Taking the absolute value of everything. This is quite a mess, like I said. You see, just like before, this negative 1 is going to vanish in the end because of the absolute values. This is good. Okay, and you see this x to 2n plus 1 power is going to cancel out here. That's why I've written it that way. So we have x squared up here. And what is this chunk right here? So this basically is just 2n plus 3 factorial. So just like before, we can rewrite this factorial as 2n plus 3 times 2n plus 2 times 2n plus 1 factorial. And you see once again, this and that is going to cancel out to a certain limit, namely the limit of x squared over, once again, those are just integers, basically natural numbers at that, not integers, positive integers, times 2n plus 3, 2n plus 2. And you see, once again, it doesn't matter which value for x you plug into here in the limit, this is going to zero as n approaches infinity, meaning equivalently that our radius of convergence is once again infinity. This basically has to do with the fact that we can express cosine and sine with respect to the exponential function with, which also has a radius of infinity right here. I hope this video helped a little bit. If it did, please like and subscribe and recommend channel if you like. You know how you can support the channel in various ways by those t-shirts I created. Support me on Patreon. And well, up until the next video, I guess, have a flammable day. See ya.